Parshas Lech Lecha begins with Hashem saying to Abraham, go for yourself, Lech Lecha, from your land, from your relatives, and from your father's house, to the land that I will show you. And then HaKadosh Baruch Hu makes all these promises, that I will make of you a great nation, I will bless you, and I will make your name great. This pasuk of Lech Lecha is the first pasuk where we really see HaKadosh Baruch Hu interacting with Amar Avinu. According to some, this is the second of the Nisyonos, the second of the tests that Avram Avinu was given, the first being the fiery furnace of Ur Kasdim. According to others, this is indeed the first test of Avram Avinu. And the question becomes, well, what exactly is this test? So according to the most normative view, the test is exactly as the pasuk tells us, of leaving his homeland, his father's house, and going to the land of the unknown. It's interesting, in the Sefer Vayomer Yehuda, he goes through the Asar Nisyonos, the 10 tests, and he expresses how each one of these tests has left an imprint on the Jewish people until today. And he notes, I've photocopied here the first six, by the bays, by the asterisks, he says in Nisayon of Lech Lecha, Shelo Idia Lo Lechan Lelechet, they didn't tell him where to go, but only to a land that I will show you. Hitmale Libo Kmiha V'Ava Gdola L'Eretz Yisrael. Filled Avraham Avinu with tremendous longing and yearning for the land of Israel. And he says, and is this, V'kach anu kibalnu kmiha atzuma la'alot l'Eretz Yisrael. And it was from this yearning and longing that we, his descendants, so too we have a yearning and longing for Eretz Yisrael. And he says, V'am Yisrael b'dor hazeh, particularly in this generation, V'yomer Yehuda is contemporary. He says, Shav l'Eretz Yisrael is returning to its land, Mitoch miha gdola, with a tremendous amount of yearning, v'hi yushalanu ma'avram avinu olav shalom, and this is something we've inherited from Avram Avinu olav shalom. And I invite any of you, if you're ever here during the summer, if you live outside of Eretz Yisrael, haven't made the big step yet, and to watch a nefesh b'nefesh flight come in, the emotion of the people coming off the plane, of making Aliyah to Israel, and the emotions of the people in this country welcoming new Olim is something that no words can even describe. And when you see such packed emotion of people literally uprooting their homes, their families, to come to Eretz Israel, you understand that this love and this yearning and this strength to do this, to make this tremendous move to the land that we know it's the first... It's a place that Kadosh Baruch Hu tells Avraham Avinu, tells his children to belong to. This is a Yerusha, an inheritance from Avraham Avinu, from this Nisayu. I'll just make mention, because it's very contemporary in terms of the political situation. In number six, he says the war with the five kings and the four kings, and Avraham Avinu going out and saving Lot, as Hishrish Banu Mitzvah Pidyon Shvuyim, has really embedded in us the importance of the mitzvah of redeeming captives. V'chol mechir at any cost. Just like Avraham Avinu went out to get Lot with his own body, and he put himself in danger. He says, even today, Am Yisrael mehader b'zeh muchanim l'achlif, alfei goyim avor yudi achad, v'chol zeh yusham Avraham Avinu olav shalom. The fact that Jews, and we've seen this today, we see this with Gilad Shalit as an example, where the Israeli government is ready to give, you know, literally tens or thousands of prisoners for one Jewish soldier. People look at this and say, is this a fair exchange? This is something we learned from Avraham Avinu. To save Lot, to save one individual, to save one Jewish soul will go to all extents. And this is how we view every single Jew, every single person who's in danger. We go out of our way to be able to do the mitzvah pidyon shvuyim to try to release these captives. Having said this, I want to, Mirtz Hashem, focus on a certain aspect of the Nisayon, and that is the way Rashi describes for us in source number 3, Lech Lecha. So Rashi notes that the Lecha to you is extra. Lech, go, would be sufficient. So Rashi teaches us, what is Lecha? It means go for your own benefit and for your own good. In Hebrew, la'anatcha u'latovatcha, for your benefit and for your good. Where you are, you're not worthy of having children and a great name, etc. Come to Israel and all these blessings will be bestowed upon you. Lech lecha, go for yourself. It's going to be of tremendous benefit for you and tremendous goodness for you if you go to the land of Israel. On this, the Mefarshim asks, and the Siva Shalom is one way to l'naseach et ha'sheila, to formulate the question. He says, uveyoter, in source 4, kashe. It's further difficult. This is one of the 10 trials Avraham Avinu was faced with. Once Hashem has given you such great promises, what is the great challenge in this, right? If somebody 7 years ago had said to me, Shira, why don't you go to the land of Israel and I'm going to make you a millionaire and bless you with children and everything's going to be good for you. So is that a challenge for me to pick up and say, okay, I'm leaving my job and my family and my friends and I'm going to Israel? It's no sweat. Wow. If someone's going to make a promise like that, of course you're going to go. So ask them, Siva Shalom and Urachayim HaKadosh asked them much earlier, many Mefarshim, what exactly is the Nisayon? What exactly is the